I just managed to get my hands on the Starlink Mini. And this is my first trip using it. So it's been a bit of a learning experience as it goes. What I'm trying to do is, can I run this thing? Can I run the Starlink Mini on the cheapest possible plan, which at the moment is $8.50 a month? And that gives you a speed of 500 kilobits per second. It doesn't sound like much, considering most of us at home are getting 50, 100, some people even getting 200 plus megabits. Megabits, not kilobits. As most of you know, it's pretty much the size of an A4 sheet of paper. It's about a centimeter and a half thick and absolutely versatile machine. Take it anywhere, connects everywhere. I've got mine mounted on the roof of the car and a cable coming in through the back door, and just plugged in straight into the rear cigarette lighter of the car. Worked flawlessly the whole way, and has been great for things like Google Maps, taking phone calls, etc., whatever. Starlink used to have, up until a month or so ago, maybe 2 months ago, there were basically three options you could choose. So there was basically an all-you-could-eat, unlimited bandwidth, unlimited downloads, somewhat unlimited, for $195 a month. Now, that was a bit out of my price range. Then there was a $80 a month for 50 gigs a month, which is somewhat doable out for a month to 6 months. You could actually put it on pause and pay nothing for that time period until you went out again. Starlink, in their infinite wisdom, have decided to get rid of the pause option. And now it is either the all-you-can-eat option, $195, still got the $80 option, but now they've got a suspend or whatever type of thing. Basically, it costs, here in Australia, it costs $8.50 Australian per month. You can still cancel your account and rejoin again later on, but I'm just trying it out on the $8.50 to see how it goes. See, what can I do for 500 kilobits per second? I'm out here in the middle of nowhere. Used it last night to download some data for Trilobite and reading the news, try to watch some videos on YouTube and email and phone my wife, etc. All those things worked. Watching the videos was probably the slowest in the olden days. Those are old enough to remember when YouTube first came out. It would every now and then stop and you'd get a spinner going around and then it would start again. Wind back the resolution, run it in 720p mode, especially if you're running it on your phone. Put it in data saver mode if you can, and try not to watch anything complicated. Are you going to be able to binge watch Netflix? No. That's just out. And that's not really what it's designed for. But it works perfectly well for reading the news. Okay, it might take a little while to get download some of the images. Facebook works a dream, no problems. Most of the reels load up fine. Some might be a bit laggy than others, but eventually they all load. That worked quite well. The big test was actually downloading the latest tenements for Trilobite. And I did that last night while sitting around watching the fire and cooking dinner. So this is a megabyte file that you have to download from Trilobite servers. Now, you may think, oh, we work it out to the 500 kilobits per second, you could work so many minutes. But that's all in the perfect world, and nothing in IT ever works in the perfect world. It's a function of how good a connection you've got. Do you have trees and blockages around you? Is it not perfectly aligned? You're pointing the wrong way, whatever. And how fast are the Trilobite servers on the other end? If they are slow, no matter how good a connection you've got, the download's going to be slow. I don't think the Trilobite ones are really super fast. They work perfectly well for most cases. But downloading the latest tenements last night took me an hour and 17 minutes to download the latest tenements. It's a long time. Am I happy with it? Not really, but you know what? I can work around it. Phone's on charge, hit the download button and get it updated. Go off, get the fire going, cook your food, wash the dishes, talk to the missus, everything else. And by the time you come back, every chance to download it, and you really haven't missed your phone at that point. Now, what is it going to be like if there's a whole bunch of people trying to access the internet at the same time? You've got kids trying to access the internet. It's probably going to take way longer to download. yep, it's time to put it aside, put it on charge. You're going to have to charge it sometime and get the download done. And then do it again tonight, whenever the next night is, and so on and so on. Am I happy with the HLR50 plan? Am I happy with the Starlink? And the overall answer is outstandingly yes. I am very happy with it. I was actually able to make calls. I'm up in the bush by myself at the moment. I was actually able to use WhatsApp to call my wife. No problems, good quality, no problems at all. Texted some friends, sent some messages, posted some pictures on various forums. Happy days. And for $8.50 a month, I'm happy to take that. Why did I buy it? Get a phone coverage and maybe get one bar or something like that. But it was on a recent attempted trip up north. I got a couple of hundred Ks out of Perth. Basically, car started having some issues, pulled over, looked at my phone, zip, zero signals. And of course, it's one of those dead spots in the on the open highway. This is when I thought, wouldn't it be cool if I had a Starlink? It's one of those times you only have to use it once. I can call someone to come and save me, fix me up, do whatever I need to do. And price paid for. Sometimes they come on a deal. I don't know when the next one is. So I paid $5.99 for mine. And I bought it directly from Starlink. I bought it through the app, the Starlink app. Can I strongly suggest, guys, that if you're going to get a Starlink app, don't go to buy something off Amazon. Don't buy something from anybody else that sells these things, any third-party providers. Forget about them. If you want a smooth, seamless sign-up period, go to Starlink. Sign up, open the app, sign up, create an account, go to the store, buy the Starlink. I bought the thing on a Sunday, paid for it Sunday lunchtime, and by Wednesday, it had been delivered to my house. You can't ask for better than that, and I'm in Perth. So, phew, amazing stuff. I opened the box. It gives you an hour's worth of free time to set up the thing, get it ready, download some updates, and this is at full speed. So I set up the account, I set up the connected to the Wi-Fi. It's all super simple to do, super simple. The whole lot took me about 15 minutes to set it up. And over that 15 minutes, I think I spent about 12 waiting for dish updates to come down the pipe. As always, like IT this button, everything's turned on, it's got to do an update, TV sets, whatever. So well worth doing it through the app. There was no problems, none of these issues in the forums. Oh, I bought this thing and this doesn't work now. Now they want an activation fee because they're buying it from dodgy providers who don't actually, not even based in Australia, buy from Starlink. You can either, I went immediately onto the thing and signed up for the $8.50 plan to try it out. Super happy with it. Fantastic little service, fantastic little app. Super easy. Well, I bought the cigarette lighter attachment plug from Starlink. It doesn't come with anything else. It just comes with a 240 volt socket. Plug it into a 240 thing, works a dream, no problems. I tried it at home, all works great. I bought a 12 volt cigarette lighter adapter. I plugged it into the rear socket of my Pajero and ran the cable out to the roof. It's got about a 5 meter cable. I fastened the dish on the roof. And I've got a homemade rack support for the dish. I wasn't prepared to pay $300 for a mount when I could make one for basically cost me nothing because I just used bits and pieces that were in my garage. And I think it's as good as any and as secure as anything. And ran flawlessly the whole way up here. No overheating, no nothing, just worked a dream. I'm in camp now at the moment. I unplugged it from my car. I ran the cables 5 meters across. I've got camper trailer, ran it across the camper trailer. The car's parked right next to the camper trailer. Plugged the cigarette lighter into the cigarette socket inside the camper trailer. And guess what? I got signal again. Super, super easy. Currently burning about 22 watts of power as it goes. So it's not going to drain your batteries flat. Do I rate it? Yes. I think it's a fantastic service. If you're going in the bush, there really is no excuse now for not having communications with family, friends, and emergency services. If you do want to, you could actually pay the $80 and get full speed. And when I use that, it's actually faster than the speed I get at home. It's actually blindingly great service. If you did go that, you could run pretty much any website you wanted to do. Pretty much takes away a lot of the thing. I'm out bush and you have to use apps. No, you can use any website you want. The world is changing, guys. The world is changing. No longer are we tied to itty-bitty phone signals and Telstra giving us the runaround. Starlink is the way to go. I recommend you get it. If you can afford it, then go for it. Thanks, guys. So I look forward to seeing you on the next video.